Okay, good morning again. Today is Friday. It is the fifth day of Cheshvan. So we continue in chapter 26 in Egeres HaKodesh, in today's Tanya. And we started yesterday with a number of questions on a quote from the Zohar that the Alter Rebbe is going to explain. And again, it illustrates how to study the Zohar, you need to have the teachings of Hasidus to be able to understand it properly. Because indeed, that part of the Zohar, people misunderstood it. And Alter Rebbe explains and brings questions on the way people understood it. And that is the Zohar that talks about that in the time of Mashiach, there will be a different type of studying, and that the tzaddikim, they will have only the Eitz HaChaim, the tree of life, referring to the mystical part of the Torah. And it refers to the revealed part of the Torah. It says this is the Eitz HaDas, Tov V'Ra, this is the tree of knowledge of mixture of good and evil. And basically that the people who are hold on to the Zohar, the mystical part of the Torah, will not need the other part. And this raises a lot of questions. The Alter Rebbe started yesterday with questions. And he continues today also with, what does that mean? That in the time of Mashiach, we will not need to know the laws of purity and impurity. And it goes to prove that we indeed, those laws will still apply even then. So if the laws apply then when Mashiach comes, they will sure need to know those laws and study those laws. So let's look inside in the Tanya. So again, this is the middle of chapter 26 of Egeres HaKodesh. Ve'oid yesh lehafli, hafli befele. There is yet further cause to be exceedingly amazed at this interpretation of what we said. Eich efshar, how is it possible? Sheli yemoysa Mashiach lo yitztachu leida ilches yisu ve'etah. In the days of Mashiach, one will not need to know the laws of prohibitions, the ritual prohibitions and permissions, things that are allowed to have, things that are not allowed to have, like kosher food and so on. Vetuma, vetara, and purity and impurity, impurity and purity. That's impossible to say so. Why? Ki eich yishchetu hakarbonis. How will you be able to perform the mitzvah of slaughtering the offerings in the Beis HaMikdash? There is a whole bunch of laws that tells you exactly how to slaughter. V'gam chulin, not only the offering in the Beis HaMikdash, if you want to have a nice barbecue, you're going to need to have a shoychet. And a shoychet will need to know all these laws. Im lo yedu hilches drasa v'chalada v'sheiyah, if they will not know the laws regarding the shechita, the slaughtering, which is drasa. Drasa means the knife. If the knife is pressed on the animal rather than being cut, that makes it not kosher. Chalada is if the knife is somewhat hidden. And it's not the proper shechita. V'shehiya also, if there is the laws of if there is a pause in the middle of the slaughtering, apois le'meshchita, those things make the shechita and disqualifies the shechita, the slaughtering. Upegimas asakin. Also, we need to make sure that the knife should be very, very smooth and there's no damage. It should be defective. So all those laws you need to know. V'chiyivolad ish betiv oy sheyeshoychet bli shehi odrasa. Will there ever be a person born by nature to know exactly how to slaughter without pausing or without pressing? And also the slaughtering knife. Will the knife be one like this that will never be blemished? So certainly, says the Alter Rebbe, those laws we will need to know. We'll need to study those laws. And many other laws of prohibitions that we will need to know. Chaylev, the dam, the certain fats of the animal that we're not allowed to eat. Those laws are not going to change. Dam, the blood, how to take out the blood from the animal, v'shari surim, and other prohibitions. But certainly we will need to know those laws. Then again, another example, says the Alter Rebbe, v'gam tumas ameis. We will also need to know the laws regarding the impurity of that is comes by a corpse when a person passes away. There's laws of impurities. This we will need to know. Why? Because people indeed will die even after Mashiach comes. Apparently, he was talking about the period before the Tchiyas HaMeisim. Kedichsiv Adar ben Meyo Shana Yamus. It says the child will pass away when 100 years old. Meaning, in a sense, we can say that means that when he passes away 100 years old, it will be considered like a child passing away. But in any case, there will be death after Mashiach comes. So we will need to know the laws regarding the tumah of the corpse, the impurities. Another example, says the Alter Rebbe, v'gam tumas yeledes tzarich leida. Also the laws of the impurity of a woman that gives birth. Just like there is a period that is impurities, there is special laws in the Torah regarding the woman that gives birth. Also, there is certain period, depending on a boy and a girl, that it is impurity involved. And that will happen also when Mashiach comes, because then also women will give birth. Dichsiv, hora v'yeledes yachdov. As the pregnant woman and one who gives birth together will be among those who will come, will be redeemed and come to the Beis HaMikdash and so on. So we'll see that. So we see there will be pregnancy and birth. But the Alter Rebbe says something even more interesting, that it says the birth and the pregnancy and the birth then will be a different types of pregnancy. Not like today that we need we're pregnant for 9 months. It says it will be conception and birth in the same day. And not only that, it says also from one conception, there could be more than one birth. She can give birth today and tomorrow and so on and so forth. That's what it says. It says, "Im teled isha b'chol yaim," if a woman will give birth every single day, mi biyo achas, from one marital union. So that will change. However, the laws of impurity will not change. Afal pike, nevertheless, din isu tumasa lo yishtane. The laws of impurity will not change. And the Alter Rebbe says, ve'ein leharich v'dovra pashut. There is no need to dwell on something which is so obvious, that there will be those laws in the time of Mashiach. Umefusim afchoy b'chol hashas medrashim. And it is the entire Talmud and the Midrashim makes known the reverse of what the misleading interpretation of the Zohar that said that when Mashiach comes, you will not need to know those laws. Indeed, in the Talmud and everywhere, it says the opposite. Everywhere. The Parich Ilchas of the Meshicha, the Talmud, questions and asks the laws of the time of Mashiach, meaning that in time of Mashiach we will need those laws. Another thing it says in the Talmud, Veliyo bal lifshet kol asfekes. Many times in the Talmud, they ask questions and there is no answer. And the Gemara ends with a word that's called teiku. Teiku means that it's sealed, that you cannot, you don't have an answer. And there is another explanation of what that teiku means. Tof yud kuf vav, which means tishbi yataretz kushyas ve'abayas, which means the Eliyahu Hanavi, the Mashiach will come, will resolve all those questions that was no answer to, meaning that at the time of Mashiach we will have answer to the questions of the laws, the problems that we had today. There's another statement that says this passage Eliyahu will expound in the future, and so on. Another thing says the Alter Rebbe, "V'oydeinu muvin mashakosuv d'lo hispanes u'tamid chachomim me'am yoretz." Another question, the Alter Rebbe continues with the questions and this interpretation of the Zoya, that we said, it said a statement that when Mashiach comes, the Talmidei Chachomim, the sages, will no longer be sustained by the illiterate people and so on. And it says, because of that, because they, v'loy me'erev rav, not from the erev rav, the mixed multitude, the achlim, posul, tamei, v'asul, chas v'shalom, that they eat from the not pure, from the forbidden, chas v'shalom, heaven forfend. So he says, that's what they explain, that when Mashiach comes, the Talmidei Chachamim will not need those laws, the way they interpret it. Why? Because they're not going to be eating from the simple folks, from the people who are illiterate folks. Says the Alter Rebbe, wait a second. That already happened. When did it happen that the scholars didn't eat from the others? They had their own. That already happened in the time of the Second Temple. And still, they studied all of those laws of the purity and impurities. So that's what Alter Rebbe says, the gam bizman bayisheni, even during the time of the Second Temple, lo yoyum ispanesim me'ami yoretz. They were not supported by the illiterate people then. The achlin, pasul, the osul, chas v'shalom. Back in the time of the Second Temple, they were not supported by the illiterate people, which ate that which is ritually unfit and so on, forbidden. Sharei talmidei chachamim, hoyelem sodoy sukromim kamei oretz, because the Torah scholars back then, they had fields, they had vineyards, just like the illiterate people. Nevertheless, they engaged in the study of the laws of Torah, of the laws of Isu, the prohibited, and the laws of impurities. They engaged in those laws. For example, all of the pairs that was the sages that lived in the time of the Second Temple, like we mentioned, the Shmaya of Aftalion and all the different peers that were studying together. And they raised disciples in the thousands and tens of thousands. So they learned all of these laws openly, and the study of the esoteric laws took place in secret, and so on. So this concludes the questions that the Alter Rebbe asked on this part of the Zohar, the way people misinterpreted. thinking that in the time of Mashiach, there will be no need to study those laws, and that they is considered the tree of a mixture of bad and good. And tomorrow, the Alter Rebbe is going to answer it. But being that tomorrow is Shabbos, so let me just give you the answer. The Alter Rebbe is going to differentiate. He said to understand that we have to understand that when we're talking about the purity and impurity, that it's called the mixture of good and bad. We're not talking about the Torah that talks about those laws. The Torah is pure. The Torah is godliness. The Torah is Eitz Chaim. The purity and impurity is talking about the objects themselves, the impure objects. Those, something which is forbidden, it's called asur, means that it's tied down in the lower levels of the impurity of the world. Those things, the tzaddikim, will no longer need to handle, because they will live in a higher spiritual world. There will be, however, the Torah doesn't change. The Torah will continue. And that, the Alter Rebbe in tomorrow's portion is going to explain in length. So this is the end of today's share. Thank you for joining. Please share. If any questions, I'll take the other questions.